Hello Primary 2, today we are gonna talk about lesson number 1, which is talking about matter. So our lesson today is talking about matter. Let's see. Everything around us is called matter. Like chair is called matter, yeah. Door is called matter. Pencil is called matter. Window is called matter. So, oil is called matter. Water is called matter. Juice is called matter. Oxygen is called matter. Air is called matter. So, everything around us is called matter. We have three types of matter, or three states of matter. Matter can be solid, matter can be liquid, matter can be gas. So we have three types of matter. They are solid, liquid, gas. Solid, liquid, gas. Solid matter, like book, like pencil, like table, like mobile phone, like computer, like door, like window, and so on. So if I ask you, table is a solid matter? Yeah. Pencil is a solid matter? Yeah. Door is a solid matter? Yeah. Window is a solid matter? Yeah. Pen is a solid matter? Yeah. All of them are solid matters. But liquid matter, like water, like oil, like juice, like milk, and so on. So if I ask you, water is a solid matter? No, water is a liquid matter. Oil is solid or liquid? Oil is liquid matter. Juice, solid or liquid? Juice is liquid matter. Milk is solid or liquid? Milk is a liquid matter. But a chair, door, table, pencil, copybook, window, and so on are solid matters. The third type of matter is gas matter. Gas matter. Gas matter like oxygen, like air, like water vapor. So, when I ask you, oxygen is solid or liquid or gas? Oxygen is gas. Air, solid or liquid or gas, is gas. Water vapor is solid or liquid or gas? Water vapor is a gas. Now let's start by solid matter. We have said that solid matter like book, pencil, table, mobile phone, and so on. So how can we know this matter is a solid? Let's see. A chair is a solid matter. You can hold the chair by your hand? Yeah, we can hold the chair by our hands. So, chair is a solid matter because we can hold it by our hands. So, you can hold the solid matter. You can move or can walk through the chair? No. We can't move or can't walk through the chair. So, we can't move or can't walk through the solid matter. So, number one, we can hold the solid matter like the chair, but we can't move or can't walk through it. So, we can hold the solid matter like the chair, like the pencil, like the table, but we can't walk or can't move through them. Why? Because the particles of the solid matter are stick together, are close to each other. So, solid matters like table, like book, pencil, pen, door, window, and so on. How can we know this matter is a solid matter? Number one, solid matter. We can hold the solid matter. We can't move or can't walk through the solid matter. The solid matter or stick together, close to each other. Number two, liquid matter. Liquid matter, like water, like oil, like juice, like milk, and so on. How can we know water is a liquid? How? Let's see. Water is a liquid. Why? Because we can hold the water by our hand. We can feel water in our hands and can walk or can move through them. So, liquid matter, number one, we can hold them by our hands. We can walk or can move through them. You can walk through the water. You can hold or can catch or can feel the water in your hand. Yeah, so water is a liquid matter. So liquids like water, like oil, like juice, like milk, and so on. How can we know water is a liquid? Number one, you can hold the water by your hand. You can feel water using your hand. Number two, you can walk or can move through the water. The particles of the water are close to each other. Close, but they don't stick to each other. They are close, but don't stick to each other. So you can walk through the water. Why? Because the particles of the water are close, but they don't stick to each other. Number three, gas matter. Gas matter, like oxygen, like air, like water vapor, and so on. How can we know air is a gas? How can we know water vapor is a gas? How can we know oxygen is a gas? You can hold or touch the air by your hand? No, you can't touch or hold the air by your hand. So air is a gas. Why? Because you can't touch it. You can't hold it by your hand. But we can easily walk through it. So, gas matter, like oxygen, like air, like water vapor. So, gas matter, you can walk through the gas matter easily, but you can't hold it. You can't hold the gas by your hands. The particles of the air are far away from each other. So the particles of the air or any gas like the air, like the oxygen, like water vapor are far away from each other. So they don't stick to each other. Do you know we can change the matter from one form to another form? We can change solid into gas. We can change liquid into solid. We can change liquid into gas. So let's see how can we change the matter from one form to another form. Let's see. How can we change liquid into solid? Liquid like what? Like the water. Solid like what? Like the ice. So how can we change water into ice by putting the water in the freezer. So we can easily change liquid like the water into solid like the ice by putting the water in the freezer. So by putting the water, the liquid in the freezer, the liquid can be changed into ice very easily. How can we change the solid matter into liquid matter? Solid matter like the ice, liquid matter like the water. So how can we change ice into water? Ice is a solid, water is a liquid. So how can we change ice into water? Solid into liquid. By putting the ice on the stove. By putting the ice on the stove. So we can easily change the solid into liquid by putting the ice into or on the stove. So we can easily change ice into water. Solid into liquid. Number three, how could we change liquid into gas? We can easily change liquid like water into gas like water vapor by putting the water on the stove. By putting the water on the stove, the liquid, the water can be changed easily into water vapor, into gas. Again, how could we change liquid matter into gas matter? We could change liquid matter easily into gas matter by putting the water on the stove. So by putting the water on the stove, water can be changed into water vapor. And this is called evaporation. Evaporation. Evaporation is the changing of the liquid into gas. Changing water into water vapor.